Hi, just wanted to put together a quick video just showing you something interesting that I put together this morning, just to show you as a sort of a bit of training, and also so that I can give it to the colleague that originally asked me for it. So what you can see here is I'm looking at the ONS website, Office for National Statistics, and the requirement was to be able to pull the latest values of a couple of bits of data from the ONS website. To be able to then bring that into ultimately into a SharePoint list, but into the Power Platform, into the Microsoft 365's tenant, so that they could then do something with that data. So what you can see here is I'm just looking at the CPI, and you can see there's a chart that's changing over time. Now, the ONS do have an API, but it's currently in beta at the moment, and I couldn't access this particular data set from that beta API. So I had to figure out a bit of a different way of getting this data. But what I was able to find is looking at this data source. If I have a look at the URL and put slash data on the end here, it's going to return me all the data that's in that time series in a fairly nice JSON format. I can't query this, I can just get the data raw. So what we're going to do is grab this data using Flow, and then we're going to try and pull the value from the months array. In here, there's a months array. You probably see it just down at the bottom there. And we're going to pull the latest value from this array. So let's head on over to Power Automate, and I'm going to create a new flow. Now, I only need this to run once a month. So just going to call this ONS data. So once a month, I'm going to set it up to run on the first of the month. Time doesn't really matter. It runs pretty quick. Repeat every month. So let's create that. So we've got our recurrence trigger. So our next step, so our first step is to fetch that data from the ONS website. So I'm just going to select my HTTP action. It's going to be a GET request, and I'm just going to paste in the URL of that data. So you can see that I'm bringing that, grabbing that from the URI. Don't need to add anything else. It's open access, so no need to authenticate. Nothing I need to pass in the header. What I do need to do, or what I do want to do, is to pass the response. So if we have a look for our pass JSON action, I'm just going to select that, and what we want to pass is the body that's come back from the HTTP. Actually, what I'm going to do is just rename these. So this is the CPI, mainly because we're going to do three requests for three separate bits of data from three separate endpoints. So we've got CPI, RPI, and AWE. So we're passing the CPI. Now, the schema, I can generate this. So if I jump back to my data here, I'm just going to highlight all of that, copy that to my clipboard, then go to generate from sample, paste that in there, and hit done. And you see that's generated the schema of my response. So this is going to tell it what it looks like. So you can see sort of a years array. There'll be a months array and a quarters array in there as well. So that's fine, and we can reuse that for the other endpoints because they do the structure is all the same. So we've got our pass CPI, and all I then need to do, let's add this into a variable. So I'm just going to add it into a variable for now, just so that I can then use it later on, maybe push it into a SharePoint list or into a database, whatever I need to. So let's just initialize a variable. So let's initialize a variable. We'll call it CPI, and we will say that it's a string. And in the value, what I want to get is the last value of the months array. So if I select my last, and then if I have a look at my part in my past CPI, there is a months array somewhere. There it is. So last value in the months. And in here, the actual property that I want is value. And we'll just click OK. Okay, so let's just check this. So let's just rename this to initialize CPI. And let's just save that. We're just going to trigger this just to make sure that we get a value in there. So if we just test this, test it all manually. So we're going to run that and we'll have a look. And there we go. We can see our value is 0.7. So looks like it's working. So let's carry on and we'll grab our other values as well. So again, we're just going to be repeating these three steps. Now, what I'm actually going to do is I'm just going to copy. So if I copy that to my clipboard, my new step, let's add that in. So we'll rename this one to RPI. And the URL for the RPI is this one. Okay, save that. And again, I'm just going to copy new step. Let's paste the pass CPI, but in this case, we're going to rename it to pass RPI. And want to change this so the body is the body of the RPI and not the body of the CPI. So that's fine. And again, let's initialize our variable. So initialize again CPI, but again this time let's rename that to RPI. And we're going to want to get the pass the value from pass RPI and not CPI. Okay, and then we're just going to repeat that. And the last one is the AWE. So let's add that in. So again, copy from our clipboard. So let's call this AWE. Update our endpoint. Okay, again, we'll be passing, rename that to AWE and update our body, the AWE body. And last step is our initializer variable. So again, let's just update this AWE and expand that. And did I change, now that's a question, did I change the name of the variable in the last step? Let's just go and check that. It's this one, wasn't it? Okay, so that doesn't appear to have worked. Oh no, there we go. I didn't update it. So RPI, what's going on with this pass? There we go, that's fine. Right, so let's save that and let's just run a quick test. Let's trigger it manually, just make sure all three are working. Let's run it, done, boom. See how quick that is. So let's just check our values. So CPI is 0.7, our RPI is 1.4 and our AWE is 4.7. So I can now take these values, I can add some additional steps in here to either those values into a SharePoint list or into a Dataverse database or do whatever I need to do with them. So hope that's been useful. You can use this with any sort of open API, do the same sort of process. But yeah, thanks for watching.